On the morning of July 2, 2023, a new volcanic eruption began on a highly populated island of France, which is home to more than 850,000 people. This eruption occurred at the Piton de la Fournaise volcano, where two fissures of lava emerged on its flanks, ejecting bombs of lava into the air to a height of 50 meters or 164 feet. For context, the Piton de la Fournaise shield volcano encompasses the eastern two-fifths of the island of Réunion, which is itself 760 kilometers east of Madagascar's eastern coastline. The eruption on the morning of July 2nd was preceded by what is known as a seismic crisis at 7:36 a.m. local time. These seismic crises occur at Piton de la Fournaise when its shallow magma chamber fills to such an extent with magma that it essentially becomes full. Yet, magma still continues to push into this region, causing pressure to build. This pressure then reaches such an extent that it causes overlying rocks to fracture, generating earthquakes. In this case, magma was rapidly moving towards the surface, resulting in more than 1,100 earthquakes in a 24-hour time span, and all of this was correctly predicted to erupt on the volcano's eastern flank, which began at 8:30 a.m. local time. The fissure formed with more than a dozen small vents erupting simultaneously along a chain of activity approximately 820 meters east of the summit crater rim of Piton de la Fournaise. This 1,000-meter-long fissure stretched from approximately 2,160 meters elevation to 1,800 meters above sea level. The maximum amount of magma fusion occurred early on, generating the highest lava fountains, as this was also when the eruption was most volatile-rich. Lava from this eruption was erupting at a fairly slow rate, likely a little less than 10 cubic meters per second, forming ropey pahoehoe lava, which did not move very fast. Despite this fact, lava has already advanced in a two-pronged flow, with the northern lobe having moved 900 meters and the southern lobe having moved 1,500 meters. This lava slowly continued to advance towards the east as this represented lower elevation, but then, volcanic tremor at the volcano once again increased. Suddenly, at 5:50 p.m. local time, a second eruptive fissure formed, but this time on the southeast flank of the volcano. These fissures are now both emitting molten rock, which, if it continues to flow for a long enough period, could, in a few days, 2 weeks' time, eventually reach a major road on the eastern section of the island. In the past 23 years, lava flows have covered sections of this road on 5 occasions before entering the ocean and adding new land to the island, with the last example occurring in 2010. However, as of the writing of this video, these roads are not yet in imminent danger. Regardless, visitation of the Piton de la Fournaise volcano is prohibited for the time being, as new fissures could form or expand with little or no warning beforehand. This eruption could last anywhere from less than 72 hours to more than a year in length, although most eruptions of this shield volcano, which is one of the planets most active alongside Kilauea, generally last around a month to a month and a half. If you are wondering why the western flank of Piton de la Fournaise has such deep ravines in a semicircular-like shape, the reason is that they represent three collapsed calderas of the volcano, which date to 250,000 years ago, 65,000 years ago, and 2700 BCE. The youngest caldera has since its formation caused 93% of this volcano's lava to flow to the east along a set path. Flank eruptions outside of this caldera have occurred, with the most recent example occurring in 1998, but there are not currently any indications that this will occur. As a result, for now, no homes or structures are at risk in this primarily effusive volcanic eruption. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.